Dear St. Andrew's students, greetings of the day. We hope you are safe at home. For the meantime, till schools are not open, we are going to study through videos. Today's chapter is from the geography portion, that is agriculture, chapter number 4. Agriculture in India. India is an agriculturally important country, as near about 80% of the people or 75+% people, they are engaged in farming activities. Agriculture produces most of the foods we consume. Agriculture also produces raw materials for the industries. Do we know that India is the second in the world in crop production next to China? We have 1.4 million square kilometers of land which is under cultivation. Agriculture in India, India's biggest economic sector. It employs nearly about 52.1% as a total workforce. Types of farming. There are three types of farming. One is primitive subsistence farming. Second is intensive subsistence farming. Third is commercial farming. The primitive subsistence farming. This type of farming is still practiced in few places in India. It is practiced on small patches with the help of primitive tools like hoe, dao, and digging sticks, and family or community labor. This type of farming depends upon monsoon, natural fertility of the soil, and suitability of other environmental conditions. It is also called slash and burn cultivation. Farmer clear a patch of land and produce crops to sustain their families. When soil fertility decreases, the farmers shift and start cultivating in the same way on a fresh patch of land. This allows nature to replenish the fertility of the soil. Productivity in this type of farming is low, as fertilizers or modern inputs are not used. Slash and burn cultivation is known by different names in India. In northeastern states, it is known as jhooming. In Manipur, it is known as pamlao. In Chhattisgarh, it is known as deepa. In Andaman and Nicobar, it is known as again deepa. In Madhya Pradesh, it is known as bevar or dhaiya. In Andhra Pradesh, it is known as podu ya penda. In Odisha, it is known as koman or bhringa. In Western Ghat, it is known as Kumri. In Rajasthan, it is known as Waller or Voltaire. In Himalayan belt, it is known as Khil. In Jharkhand, it is known as Kuruba. These are the local names which are termed for slash and burn in India. In rest of the world, mostly in those areas where we have early civilization, there it is known by different names. For example, in Mexico and Central America, it is known as milpa. In Venezuela, it is known as conuco. In Brazil, it is known as roca. In Central Africa, it is known as masol. In Indonesia, it is known as ladang. In Vietnam, it is known as rei. So these were some of the names by which we can call slash and burn by different other names in different locality. Intensive subsistence farming, this is the second one. This type of farming is practiced in areas of high population pressure on land. It is a labor intensive farming where high doses of biochemical inputs and irrigations are used for obtaining higher production. Though the right of inheritance leading to the division of land among successive generation has rendered land holding size uneconomical, the farmers continue to take maximum output from the limited land in the absence of alternative source of livelihood. Thus, there is enormous pressure on agricultural land. In this intensive farming, we see that there is a, it is a labor intensive, and it a lot of capital has been invested in buying biochemical products or inputs, and then we should have a proper irrigation methods. So basically we invest in tube wells or electric wells which can continuously provide irrigation facilities. So it thus it becomes an intensive agriculture farming. Then the third one is commercial farming. In this type of farming, high doses of modern inputs like high yielding variety seeds, chemical fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides are used in order to obtain the higher production. The degree of commercialization varies from region to region. For example, rice is a commercial crop in Punjab and Haryana, but in Odisha it is a subsistence crop. Then we have next one is a plantation agriculture. Plantation is a type of commercial farming. This type of farming in which single crop is grown on a large area. The plantation has an interface of agriculture and industry. Plantation use capital intensive inputs. With the help of migrant laborers, all the produce is used as in raw material in respective industries. Tea plantation in Assam and North Bengal, coffee plantation in Karnataka, banana plantation in southern part of India, rubber plantation in Kerala, bamboo plantation in Northeast, etc. are grown in India. Since the production is mainly for market, a well-developed network of transport and communications connecting the plantation areas, processing industries and market is present. Cropping pattern in India. India has a three cropping season, which are Rabi crop, as a number one, second one is Kharif crop, and the third one is Zayat crop. Rabi crops. It is sown in winter from October to December and harvested in summer from April to June. Important crops are wheat, barley, peas, gram, mustard. States such as Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Uttarakhand and Western Uttar Pradesh are main Rabi crop areas. Availability of precipitation during winter month is due to the western temperate cyclones helps in succession of these crops. These western cyclones, they erupt in Mediterranean seas and then they overblown over the Indian subcontinent, and we have the states Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, western parts of Uttar Pradesh, Jammu, Kashmir, all this area they receives a good amount of rainfall during winter season, which is very essential for the growth of Rabi crops. The success of Green Revolution in Punjab and Haryana, along with western Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan, has also been an important factor for the growth of Rabi crops. As we have seen, the major crops which are under Rabi crops, those are wheat, mustard, peas, gram, etc. Kharif crop, sown during the time of onset of monsoon in different parts of the country and harvested in the months of September and October. Important crops are paddy, maize, jowar, bajra, tur, ahar, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soybean. Some of the most important rice growing regions are Assam, West Bengal, coastal region of Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Maharashtra. Particularly the Konkan coast along with the Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. Recently, paddy has also become an important crop of Punjab and Haryana. In states like Assam, West Bengal and Odisha, three crops are grown for paddy. They are Os, Aman and Boro. Zayat crops is the third one. Zayat season is short season between Rabi and Kharif crop. During the summer months, crops produce are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetable and fodder crops. Major crops are of India are rice, wheat, millets, maize, pulses. These are termed as grains. Then we have sugarcane, oil seeds, tea, coffee, horticulture crops. These are terms as food crops other than grains. Then the third category is rubber, fiber crops, cotton, jute. They are termed as non-food crops. Thanks for watching. We'll look for the detailed discussion related with the grains, the food crops other grains and not food crops under the broad heading that is a major crops in the next segment. In this segment we have learned about different types of farming, that is intensive farming, extensive farming and plantation agriculture along with the commercial farming. And we have also studied about the three cropping pattern we have in India. The first one is rabi crops, then we have kharif crop, then the third one is the zayat crops. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.